The state of Louisiana is losing ground, literally.
Louisiana is losing land faster than anywhere else in the United States, arguably faster than anywhere in the world. We lose marsh at the rate of about a football field per hour, which is crazy to think about. One of the big drivers of that is sea level rise, and it's going to continue for some time.
Louisiana is on the front lines of the global crisis of sea level rise. At risk is billions of dollars in fishing and shipping infrastructure, as well as the lives of millions who depend on the coast for their way of life.
That's why our mission is so critical. We're going to live and work in the coast, and so we're going to have to figure out how to do that.
Throughout Earth's history, sea level has risen and fallen, linked to the ups and downs of global temperature. What's different now is that sea level is rising more quickly than ever due to human-caused climate change. Compounding the challenge is the fact that nearly half of the world's population lives within an hour of the coast. Relocating would mean the devastating loss of communities and cultures. One country has spent centuries thinking about how to live below sea level. The Netherlands.
We are sailing along our windmills, which are built in 1738 and 1740. And even we have an older one, which is from the year 1632. They are here only for one purpose, and that's pumping water. We live here about 6 feet below sea level, so if we don't do anything, we will drown.
Adaptation is expensive.
So officials from Louisiana have come here to learn firsthand about what works.
Here in the Netherlands, whatever they do, whatever they build, whatever goals they have, water management is in the forefront of their mind.
Dutch engineering has long focused on inventing systems to keep the water out. Now, the country is adopting a new approach to let the water in. They are making room in both urban and rural spaces for increased floods.
Over there you see a terrace with some pieces of art and benches to relax, but it's also an extra water storage because when it starts to rain, water levels rise and these terraces floods, but it's able to do so. We really used to think of water as an enemy, but if we design the city in the right way, we can really embrace the water and live with it.
Across the world, cities like Rotterdam are facing the same choice, to fight the water or learn to live with it.
I believe that every city has to certainly evaluate what's going on in their community and not ignore the signals, but do the research, collect the data, and come up with some viable solutions.
Those solutions may be as old as nature itself.
Along the Dutch coastline, we want to work with building with nature. Building with nature is a new concept, more nature-based and less engineered solutions. We want to use the forces of wind and water and sand to create a more sustainable coastal flood protection.
Building with nature is the idea behind the Zandmotor, an artificially constructed peninsula. Millions of tons of sand were moved here to protect the coast from storm surges.
If you look behind me, you'll see a big beach that wasn't there before. It was just ocean. It creates a barrier against sea level rises.
Unexpectedly, that barrier also created new areas for recreation.
This spot is very special to me as a nature lover, as a kite surfer. It's just a joy to be here every day.
In Louisiana, building with nature is starting to take hold. For thousands of years, the Mississippi River deposited sediment that created protective marshes and barrier islands. But then we disrupted that system with levees that cut off the natural supply of new land.
All of southern Louisiana was built by the Mississippi River, and we need to reproduce that effect so that we can start building those coastal defenses again.
Sea level scientists are working to determine how much the ocean will rise and how quickly. But for coastal communities, delay is no longer an option.
There's large uncertainty about what kind of sea level rise we will get into the future. And this uncertainty sometimes stops people from acting. But despite this uncertainty, we need to start preparing and implement actions, because if we don't, we may not have enough time